Hey, are you thinking about moving to Chesterfield, Virginia? Well, in this video, I really want to break down the area of Chesterfield before you make that move. So let's go. If this is your first time to my channel, stop what you're doing, like the video, subscribe now so I can alert you with more videos like this in the future. Now, Chesterfield is pretty big. Some people get confused because they're confused with South Chesterfield, North Chesterfield, and then you can start from the bottom of Chesterfield, which is South Chesterfield, and go all the way up to Midlothian area, and it takes a good 45 minutes to drive. So people get confused, is Chester in Chesterfield? Is Midlothian in Chesterfield? What is Enon? What is South Chesterfield? What is Ettrick, Matoka? We're gonna talk about all these things today so that you can really understand Chesterfield. Now, one of the main reasons people like to move to Chesterfield because it's the outskirts of the Tri-City areas, of Richmond, Colonial Heights, and Petersburg area. Most people want to live on the outskirts. A lot of people like their school system. Now, as a licensed realtor, I can't say what I think is the best schools in the area, but I always go to niche.com to give the schools a different rating. They give you different ratings like A+, A-, B+, and so forth. Now you can go to greatschools.org or different websites to kind of get your different rankings of schools. But today we're going to just target the high schools. And it's 11 total high schools in Chesterfield, Virginia. 11. So we're going to go over all of those today and we're going to break down the different areas. There's 16 different zip codes in the area as well. So sometimes when people move to the area, it can be overwhelming because they're saying, hey, I want to be close to my job, but I want to live in Chesterfield. So it depends on what part of Chesterfield you're talking about. Some people move to Fort Gregg Adams. They're like, hey, I want Chesterfield, but I don't want to be 45 minutes away. So we're going to really go over these different areas today so you can really hone in on what area may fit for you and your family. Okay, let's get into the high schools. We're just going to discuss high schools. We're not getting into middle schools and elementary. Like I always say, do your due diligence when it comes to your schools for your children. We're going to use niche.com today. So, you know, niche.com ranked their schools as A+, A-, B+, B-, C, and so forth, okay? So we're just going to focus on the high schools of Chesterfield. There are 11 high schools that's in Chesterfield, okay? We're going to start off with number one, and number one is Clover Hill. Clover Hill comes in as an A rating school. Now, remind you, other sites you may go to, like greatschools.org or different other sites, they might put another school at number one. But those top three or four, they usually mix them up. But you're going to get a good understanding of what are your top schools in Chesterfield, according to niche.com. Okay, so you have Clover Hills, number one. Number two is Cosby. Cosby High School is rated as an A as well. Number three is Midlothian. Midlothian is rated as an A. And then number four is James River. That's at an A-. So four of your schools are ranked in the A range, which is great when it comes to Chesterfield out of 11 high schools, okay? Then you have Matoka. Matoka is at a B. Then you have Minokin. Minokin comes in as a B+ as well. And then you have Manchester. Manchester, which is number seven on the list, comes in as a B. Then you have number eight, Thomasdale. Thomasdale High School comes as a B. And then number nine, LC Bird comes in as a B-. Then number 10, you have Carver College and Career Academy comes in as a B-. Then last but not least, you have Meadowbrook High School, which comes in at a C rating. So you can see why some people come to the area for the school system. Out of the 11, there's only one school, which is Meadowbrook, coming in a C. But the other ones is rated as an A and a B. So a lot of times that affects your price point as well. So when you get your A rating schools, your price point of your home is going to be a little higher than your B, than your C, of course. But as I'm going through this video, when you hear the different schools, you're going to understand what's the A rating schools, what's the B rating schools. Once again, number one, Clover Hill. Number two, Cosby. Number three, Midlothian. Number four, James River. Then number five, Matoka. Number six is Monica. Number seven is Manchester. Number eight is Thomasdale. And then number nine is B-, LC Bird. And then number 10, Carver College and Career Academy. And then number 11 is Meadowbrook High School. So let's get right into it and let's break down Chesterfield. Now we have 16 total zip codes when it comes to Chesterfield. You have Mosley, Midlothian, Chesterfield, Chester, North Chesterfield, South Chesterfield. So people get confused, like, is Chester in Chesterfield? Yes. So we're going to start off with South Chesterfield. South Chesterfield has two zip codes, 23834 and 23803. Some people get this confused because 23834 is very close to Colonial Heights. So some people feel that it's Colonial Heights. Also, 23803 is the same area code, the same zip code as Petersburg. So people would think that's Petersburg, but it's not. Those school systems in that area, that is your Matoka area in 23803. That's the Ettrick area. You're going to hear Ettrick, you're going to hear Matoka if you're in South Chesterfield. You're going to hear those names, and definitely Matoka High School, because that's South Chesterfield. Now, what's crazy is when you get to 23834 of South Chesterfield, that high school that you're attending over that way is Thomasdale High School. Now, remember, South Chesterfield is at the bottom of Chesterfield. It's very close to Colonial Heights, very close to Petersburg, Dinwiddie. If you're thinking about moving or have to move to Fort Gregg Adams, this is the area of South Chesterfield that you might want to look into. They're building several homes in that area. We just closed on a D.R. Horton home, so they're building some homes out there in South Chesterfield. There's a lot of different schools that's in that area. Now, if you're in that South Chesterfield, you can go north, of course, and you're going to enter to another part of South Chesterfield, and we're going to get deep into that, okay? But right now, we are talking about that South Chesterfield area, and you have 23834 and you have 23803 that's in that area. Two of your zip codes, close to Colonial Heights, close to Petersburg, Dinwiddie, Prince George, close to Fort Gregg Adams, just FYI, South Chesterfield. Now let's go to North Chesterfield. Is that South? Now we're at North Chesterfield. Now North Chesterfield has six zip codes, six. I'm gonna have to cheat. I gotta look a little bit at these zip codes because it's a lot. You have 23224, 23225, 23234, 23235, 23236, 23237. So you have six total. I don't know if I said 23225 and 23235. It gets a little confusing. If you're from the area, people will call some of this area south side of Richmond. Technically, it's in Chesterfield. It is very close to Richmond of the south side. Now, I'll give you an example, that 23234, you're going to have your Meadowbrook High School. You're going to have a little bit of your Bird High School that's in that area. Different neighborhoods. And then, what's cool about North Chesterfield, you have 23235. That's with James River High School and Manchester High School. You also have a mall that's in that area in Chesterfield Town Center. That's in the North Chesterfield, very close to Richmond. Also, 23235, you have Stony Point, which is a nice mall area. So your malls are in that North Chesterfield area. Also, let me go back to South Chesterfield. You do have a mall, which is South Park Mall, which is in South Chesterfield area, but it's in Colonial Heights, okay? It's not in Chesterfield, but it's Colonial Heights, very close to South Chesterfield. So North Chesterfield, South Chesterfield, you have a lot of your shopping centers and where people can go shopping in those two areas. Okay, now let's move to 23836. We already talked about North Chesterfield, we talked about South Chesterfield, then we're going to the east side of Chesterfield. And that mailing address for 23836, it is Chester. But if you're from the area, most of the people call that area Enon. So the Enon area is very close and it borders Hopewell. Hopewell, you do have a hospital that's that way. So if you're thinking about being close to the hospital in Hopewell, 23836 is a great area when you think about living in Chesterfield. Now, the high school for 23836 is Thomasdale High School. Now, this area is close to the James River. Close to 295. You're about 5 minutes away from 95. Now, don't forget your North Chesterfield, South Chesterfield, all those are pretty close to 295 because 295 comes up just like that. But once again, we're going to the east, through the east of 23836, which is called the Enon area. Now, 23836 is really growing with a lot of traffic in that area because you have an Amazon that's way. You also have a Lego company that's coming up as well. It's not there yet, but it should be coming soon. So they changed a lot of the traffic patterns around here. And also you have different neighborhoods, a lot of residential, Rivers Bend, Meadowville Landing, Ramblewood, Cypress. You have different popular neighborhoods that's in 23836. Now, let's go to 23831. Like I said, North Chesterfield, South Chesterfield. We went to the east end of 23836. Now we're going to go to 23831, which is Chester. That is the area you would hit in Chesterfield. It's Chester. Chester is in Chesterfield. You're going to hit this area off of 95. Once you come off of 95, you have a Chester exit, you have a Hopewell exit. So right there, you're going to see a lot of different amenities and different things and eateries that's in that area, that 23831. 23831 also goes to Thomasdale. Some of those neighborhoods, they will go to Elsieburg. You have Wellington Farms, you have Long Meadow, different popular neighborhoods. Like I said, I can't get into every neighborhood that's in Chesterfield. It's a ton of them. If you figure out the area you're in high school, feel free to reach out to me and say, hey Chris, what about that area? I'm gonna know some of the neighborhoods that's in that area, maybe at certain price points, because there's so many different price points in Chesterfield, period. I mean, you can find a house, decent house, for $250 to $2 million, $3 million. I mean, Chesterfield's big. And when you're talking about the 23831 area, which we're talking about right now, you can find some homes and townhouses at different price ranges, $350,000 to $400,000. You can find a nice $800,000 house with some space. It just really depends on what you and your family are looking for. Once again, that's the Thomasdale area, 23831. Okay, moving along. Thanks for hanging there with me. It can seem kind of boring, but if you're moving to the area, this is a video you definitely want to check out to learn the different zip codes and where you're going to be in Chesterfield. Next one we're going to get to is 23832. It was in 23831, now we're in 23832. Okay, North Chesterfield, South Chesterfield. Went to the east end, then we're kind of going through the middle to 23831. Now we're at 23832. As you're going down Route 10, and it turns into Iron Bridge. Iron Bridge, and the things that you're going to have on that is like your courthouse. If you get a speeding ticket, you're going to be in that 23832 area. Also has an airport, a little airport, not Richmond RIC, but it's a little airport that's in that 23832 area. A lot of different things that's over there. A ton of neighborhoods that's in 23832. You have Burkdale, Hoppers Mill, Willow Creek. So it's a different popular neighborhoods in the area. Like I said, I can't go over all of them. And in that area, you want to remember, you're about 45 minutes away from Fort Gregg Island, roughly 40 to 45 minutes. Just depends on where you're at, because 23832 is pretty large. And that school, the schools in that area, you have Clover Hill, you have Manchester, and you have Cosby, FYI, 23832. Then if we keep on moving, we're at 23838. That's a little more of a country area. You're not too far from 23832. You're not too far from South Chesterfield, believe it or not, in this area of 23838. Some of the popular neighborhoods over there, some nice neighborhoods. You're on Lake Chesden, a neighborhood in that area, and then you're also closer to Highlands. Golf communities. If you like playing golf, that's the area you need to think about. 23838, very nice area. To me, it's like a country setting. You want to be away from things just a little bit. I mean, you're only 15 minutes away from some of your different stores, but that's something to think about. Some of your high schools in that area is Metoka for sure, and some of it is Cosby as well. 23838. Okay, now we're going to 23236. That area, you have Monacan High School, Clover Hill High School as well. Different areas, different neighborhoods. Ashley Wood, they're building out there at Bethany Creek. Then you have 23112. All of these are pretty close together. You have Foxcroft neighborhood, Wood Lake, very popular neighborhood, Deer Run. That's that Midlothian, Virginia area. You have Cosby, your Clover here as your high schools. Nice little area when it comes to your Commonwealth movie theater. Nice bowling alley back there. That's a very popular strip, which is Hall Street off of 288. Most of these areas off of 288 here. 23236. Your 23112 is close to 288. Your 23113, that's gonna turn into Midlothian, Virginia. okay? So you're in Chesterfield, but it's still Midlothian, Virginia. Of course, when you're in Midlothian, Virginia, you have Midlothian High School, you have James River. As we talked earlier, those are A-plus schools. Westchester Commons, popular area where you can do your shopping. It's a ton of things up that way. Once again, you're kind of up top of Chesterfield versus South Chesterfield versus North Chesterfield versus the East End, because it's doing this. North Chesterfield, it connects, but it's going up further north. Okay, I hope I'm not covering my face in the camera. It's going further north. You're catching that 288 flow. You got 95 over here, but that 288 flow is coming up there in your Midlothian, Chesterfield area. Okay, so in that area, you're going to find a lot of your A-ranking schools, as we talked about earlier. Your Clover Hill, your Midlothian, your James River, your Cosby. That area, that Midlothian area, you're gonna see your number one schools in that area. When you get into your 23114 area of Chesterfield, like I said, that's up at the top. You have a hospital up there, Bonsecur St. Francis Hospital, that's in that area. Then you're talking about your Midlothian High School that's in the area as well. And you have a lot of new construction, a lot of different things is going on in that area as well. And then we're gonna just go straight to 23120. That's your Moseley, Virginia. Once again, we're up there a little bit, up there when it comes to Chesterfield. It just seems like another world to me when it comes to Chesterfield in that area, because people call it Moseley. Some people call it, of course it's called Moseley and it's called Midlothian area, but some people don't refer to Chesterfield sometimes, but it is in Chesterfield. Those areas are in Chesterfield. Even in that 23120 area, in that zip code, you have the Richmond Zoo that's right around there. You have Magnolia Green, you have Fox Creek. Some of your high schools is Cosby, which once again is ranked as that A-rated school. So if you can just put in your mind when it comes to Chesterfield, it's this. You have your Moseley, you have your Midlothian, the A-rating schools in that area, and you're going up 288, okay? A lot of traffic sometimes, not a whole lot, but there could be traffic up that way, okay? But as you're going down, you can get into your 23832 area and a little bit of that rural area when it comes to Chesterfield. And then it kind of moves over to the East End. You have that North Chesterfield and you have that South Chesterfield, okay? So Chesterfield can be pretty big. It can be overwhelming sometimes, but if you just think about it in that way, North Chesterfield, South Chesterfield, you have the East End of the Enon area of Chester, then you're kind of moving on up to your Midlothian and to your Midlothian and Moseley area. In Chesterfield, they're doing a ton of building. If you're looking for a new home, man, I suggest you check out the area for sure, because they're building a whole lot of new homes, new construction. I'm going to have different videos in the area as well, because it's something to think about if you're moving to the area. And if you're trying to be close to Fort Gregg Adams, it's a little distance. You're up here. Fort Gregg Adams is here. But if you want to be closer to Short Pump, it's not too far, because once you keep up 288, you're about 20 minutes away when you're in that Midlothian area. It depends on what part. And if you want to be close to the city, you're only 20 minutes away, roughly, as well. So anywhere you're in Chesterfield, it's pretty nice. It got its pros and cons. It depends on the area and the location where you want to be. But like I said, please feel free to reach out to me. Just let me know which zip code that you're looking at. We went over the different schools that's in each zip code, and it might fit you and your family. I can tell you about the new construction in any of the zip codes, because they're building everywhere. But they're building real heavy in that Midlothian, Moseley area, which I highly recommend take a look at if you're thinking about new construction. If you just want to be on the outskirts of any of the city, like Richmond, Tri-City of Petersburg, Colonial Heights, if you want to be away from all that, but close, Chesterfield is definitely an answer for you. Even if you're talking about that North Chesterfield, which is super close to Richmond, I highly suggest looking into those areas. Like I always say, I don't care if you're thinking about moving next week, next month, or next year. Please reach out to me and my team, because we'd love to help you make that smooth move to Chesterfield, Virginia.